Cystic fibrosis fills your lungs with fluid, makes every breath a struggle. It's like drowning on the inside. Help us stop CF from swallowing young lives. Be a lifeline. Be the reason someone with cystic fibrosis keeps breathing.
Ah, my dear doctor.
What is that delightful human phrase? Now let me see.
Ah, yes. Born in a barn.
It's had a short time and had changed in 1989.
Well, I suppose the main thing is that...
How did that get in here?
Doctor?
Chris, stop it. You're going to kill yourself. You're about to overdose.
Are you alright, baby?
I think so. I don't know what's just happened to me.
That was so scary.
I knew my hat and coat stand would come in handy one day. Are you okay?
I think so. What the hell just happened to me?
Oh, Tom.
What?
I'll explain later. The main thing is you're okay.
Doctor, there's something you need to know.
But how did that get in here?
It's about a friend of mine. To be honest, you're better off just looking at this.
Often, I dreamt of a blue box flying through space. Chris, who is this Peter? This is serious.
Well, he's a cystic fibrosis friend of mine. He makes videos as a hobby.
Where did he get that information from about a time lord inhabiting Earth?
Details? Well, anyway, he told me that most of his good film ideas come from his dreams.
Dream? He must have some form of ESP.
Right, I don't mean to be rude here, Doc, because it's confusing enough as it is. Why are we now talking about an American sports channel?
Extrasensory perception, it's a form of sixth sense.
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah, you must have. What's that got to do with the film?
Does he have more dreams like this?
Well, it would appear that he does actually, because he sent me this document a while ago and he said, Chris, don't send it to anyone else.
I'd like to have a look at that.
So apparently that film was only a small part of this.
Explains a lot. Chris, this document and film that Peter's made explains why Earth is often targeted for invasion.
Targeted?
Well, the aliens mentioned the great enemies of the Time Lords. I was there on the last day of the Time War. Am managed to get quite a few refugees into the TARDIS and brought them back to Earth. However, as your friend got partly right, Time Lords require supplements Earth doesn't offer, so I turned to UNIT for help.
What do you want? Well, facilities, laboratory equipment, help from Miss Shaw here?
We use cystic fibrosis as cover, as Time Lords, like CF people, require food supplements with meals and procedures for their lungs to strengthen them to adapt them to planetary atmosphere.
Are you saying what I think you're saying?
That treatments used for cystic fibrosis are also beneficial to Time Lords. Yep. The thing is, someone's been following me recently.
The Daleks.
If only it was. The Daleks aren't one for changing timelines or faking them. It seems someone has been manipulating the TARDIS. The timeline wasn't changed, but was set up to get me to travel to 1989. Someone's trying to kill me.
Trakan Union, famous for its universal harmony, a whole empire held together by...
By?
Well, by people just being terribly nice to each other.
Adric? I can't see Trakan. Master killed my stepmother. And then my father. And now the world that I grew up in.
It all makes sense now. The Master must have somehow linked his Staten remote control to my TARDIS and sent me to Trakan in an attempt to wipe me out along with the planet.
Excellent deduction, my dear Doctor. Such a pity you didn't stick around for just a little longer. Am I to take it to enjoy the little gift I left for you?
Yeah, it was so kind of you.
Oh, not at all. Simply a little thank you after what you did.
Well, we don't want regenerating Saberman, do we?
I definitely said no plus ones.
Where I go, they go now.
Cybermen. Oh, useless creatures. Though I'll admit they had their uses in the Death Zone.
This is not the Doctor.
Take him.
I've been looking for you.
Kill him.
I'm here as your friend.
Of course, their stupidity got the better of them.
Like I said, so kind. But to lure me back to 1989.
As if I'd waste my time luring you anywhere.
Yeah, lure me.
It was simply my good fortune that we were in the same place at the same time, Doctor.
Like I said, thanks to you.
Well, that TARDIS of yours has always been a little temperamental. And I must congratulate you on destroying that university. Very impressive. Though your tendency to leave destruction in your wake surprises me no more.
What? Will I be?
What's he going on about an explosion for? I thought that never happened.
I don't know. I thought... The Master thought I was referring to the Death Soul and Gallifrey when I mentioned Cybermen. Not the Cybermen he created when I last visited Gallifrey.
If you're saying the Master didn't cause the explosion and the timeline is normal, then why is he saying that you caused it?
But there was no explosion. Though, wait a sec. got no choice but to do this.
What's that?
Not that I'm blaming your friend, but that film has risked the lives of many, including yours.
What do you mean?
Okay. I might as well tell you.
Tell me what?
Well, Black Chi and his research team, and you think they are?
No.
I mean, they are geneticists, but not human.
No. Are you telling me?
Time Lords? Yeah, I guess I am. They're the refugees saved during the Time War.
Even the legendary Professor Webb?
No, he doesn't know anything about this. Otherwise, he wouldn't have helped make that film, which according to the timeline, has increased the risk of alien invasion.
Oh.
Yeah. I've compared the current timeline with the one thought was fabricated by the Master.
And?
Well, if the university did blow up, that would reduce the risk of alien invasion considerably.
At the cost of many lives, wouldn't it just be better to delete the video?
I'm afraid not. You know how many people have seen the film. I'm afraid.
Afraid?
I'm gonna have to destroy the university.
Are you positive this is gonna work?
Oh, absolutely. I've just realised I've already tested it.
What? When?
I'm just sending the fabricated timeline back to when we were talking earlier and got cut off.
Hey?
You know, before I got attacked by the Auton. I mean, I managed to fool myself to the point where I fell for it, therefore the Master.
Has fallen for it too? What a mug!
Yep.
You can consider what has been accomplished here in an analogy of climbing a mountain. And this is a mountain that nobody's ever climbed before. And the top of the mountain is called having a treatment that cures this disease. What we've done and are talking about today is establishing a very prominent camp along that way, which allows us to look forward and have a much better idea of where we're going.
When that day came where we could see, here is a gene never before described that has three letters missing in most people with cystic fibrosis, that was a revelation. We finally now have the cause in front of us. It took a little longer than I hoped it would. Well, we got there. Somebody sent me this charming entry. Today is the most best day ever in my life. They found a GEAN gene for cystic fibrosis. That kind of summed it all up. It was a long, tough road, a road that many people predicted would end in failure, and look where we are. I wrote a song about this hope.
Dare to dream, dare to dream. All our brothers and sisters breathing free. Unafraid, our hopes unswayed. Till the story of CF is history.
That's what we're all aiming for. We are so much closer to that. We're gonna keep at this until CF really is history.